Hi there, I'm meteorologist Jason Dunning. Hope you're having a nice Friday night. We certainly saw some pretty stormy weather for much of Southwest Florida tonight, but what I want to talk to you about is a little tropical disturbance that we're watching down in the Caribbean right now, and it's not going to affect us until early next week. So we're okay through the weekend on Saturday and Sunday. But I'd like to encourage you to stay weather aware this weekend because things are very dynamic here when we deal with the tropics. Things can change very quickly. The bottom line, we do expect to see some impacts from whatever this tropical disturbance ends up being, whether it's just an area of low pressure, a tropical depression, or perhaps a tropical storm Colin. The National Hurricane Center currently gives this area, as of around 9:45 on Friday night, a 70% chance to develop into a tropical system. So that would be at least a tropical depression. The good news is we do not expect this to intensify into a hurricane. So that's something that I think we don't need to worry about. It would be highly unlikely in these conditions for this to intensify into a hurricane. There's a lot of wind shear in the Gulf of Mexico. But let me show you what our high resolution forecast model has and how it develops the system beyond the weekend. I want to start here by 7 a.m. on Sunday. By then, the system will just be coming north of the Yucatan Peninsula, and that's where we'll really have a better idea when we'll be able to key in on how organized the system will be and what kind of impact specifically that we'll see here in Southwest Florida. As we look ahead to Sunday evening, we've got developing low pressure back off toward our west, and then it looks like as early as Monday morning is when we could start feeling the impacts of this. Likely a lot of heavy rain, winds will start to pick up. Notice the actual area of low pressure, and you can sort of find it there by looking at the arrows where they circulate. It's still back off to our west, but all of the rain will be displaced from the center. Everything will be on the east and southeastern side. So even though you might see the center of the storm go north of here and even north of Tampa, we're going to see a lot of these rain bands, all of this tropical moisture spread toward the Florida west coast and even here in southwest Florida. And that's going to mean 2 days likely of rainy weather and even some stormy weather. It's not out of the question to see some isolated severe storms. That sometimes happens when we have even weak tropical systems. These spiraling rain bands can produce isolated severe weather, even some brief weak tornadoes. So that's something else we'll have to pay attention to. As far as the rainfall potential, we could see anywhere from 3 to 6 inches, some models showing 4 to 7 inches in that 2 day span. And whenever you get so much rainfall in such a short amount of time, it can certainly lead to some flooding issues. And I think that's really going to be the highest threat for us in Southwest Florida on Monday and Tuesday, flooding with the heavy rain expected, especially when you get 4 to 7 inches. Some lightning, although I think that would be a lesser threat, wind threat in the medium range. This is potentially a tropical system, so it could get a little bit breezy. And then I have tornado there at a medium threat because sometimes with these weak tropical systems, as we talk about, the way these cells sort of spiral around, it could cause some issues with those isolated tornadoes. So there we are again with that little system in the Caribbean. The weekend will be fine, just some scattered afternoon storms. Just pay close attention to the weather. Meteorologist Rob Duns, Kristen Kershane will be giving updates throughout the weekend. Hope you have a safe weekend, and I'll see you again next week.